I honor you, beautiful divine souls. And I feel guided to film this video and to share with you this short message that I received in today's meditation. Before filming any video, usually I go in a meditation and I ask my higher self, I ask God, I ask my spiritual guides to share with me, or if they have any message for humanity. And this is the message that I received today from God when I merge with its presence, and it's beautiful. I feel it's part of my duty to share it with you, and I wish it will help you to pass with grace through these moments of interesting changes that are happening around the world. So I did this meditation where I dive deeper into my heart and I pass through this portal of light, and I see and I feel this infinite ocean of love. I embrace it, I merge with it, and I ask, God, please let me know if you have any message for humanity. Its message was full of love and very short. Its message was for us to come home. This infinite ocean of light is welcoming us home. This energy is missing us. He wishes for you to remember how sacred and holy you are, because you are part of its essence. Its message was, come home. Tell humanity to come home. Our hearts are the portals where we can connect with its essence. And because we are beings of love, we have the power to connect with this infinite essence in every second of our days. The archonic consciousness, those beings who wishes to control humanity, decided to disconnect from the source with their free will. And they brainwash us to do the same. And the more negative scenarios, the more negative actions they are doing towards humanity, towards all life, the more far away they are from the source. They are just adding more layers and more layers of traumas and negative feelings, which will push them away from the source. And it's our duty, the ones who can connect with their hearts, the ones who are more open to receive these light codes, the ones who wishes to ascend, to send them love, for them to remember how is the feeling of love, because they are so lost. I still find it hard to understand or to accept when we let these beings, these unhealed beings, to control us, to take decisions for us. When? just ask yourself why we let these beings that are disconnected from the source to take decisions for us when they don't have any inner guidance. Why? I still don't understand it. Everything is infinite on this planet and in the universe. Why we are allowing these unhealed beings to limit us, to make us think that we are victims, to brainwash us that we need a vaccine to survive? We need to give more credit to our bodies. I understand that the system didn't share with us the majesty of our bodies, but really, these vehicles are divine. We don't need any type of vaccine. And why we are still believing their scenarios every time they are creating a different problem afterwards for them to come with a solution. So why? We know that their intentions are not pure. You have the power to say no, as I said it many times in my other videos. You have the power to raise the consciousness of humanity by going within you and connect with God from within. As many people said it before, the outer world is a manifestation of the inner world. And when we start being center, balance, and in a state of love, our outer world will be that manifestation of love. The organic timeline is the light at the end of the tunnel. We are still in the tunnel right now and not much makes sense, but the light at the end is shining brighter and brighter. When we connect with God from within, we start serving the divine, because what God wishes for us is to become one with its creation. Nothing else makes sense than serving the will of God. Nothing else makes sense than you being in a state of love, sharing that love with your dear ones, with Gaia, with all the creation. For such a long period of time, we have been disconnected from the source, from our hearts, because we was brainwashed over and over again, and we cannot continue like this anymore. We lived in an artificial timeline in a loop for thousands of years. It's time for us to take responsibility, moving from 3D to 5D. It is a huge quantum leap, and 5D, it's about responsibility, self-responsibility. 5D, it's about instant manifestation. So you have to be responsible about what you think, about how you feel. 5D, it is the union of God. It is infinite potential of you creating everything you think with your heart. 5D, it's about expanding your consciousness and understand that we are not alone in the universe. The creation of God is infinite, And 5D is all about experiencing the beauty of God. So choose the light at the end of the tunnel. Choose the organic timeline of love. Another thing that I feel guided to share to you is the importance of meditating daily. Because everything is coming to the surface right now. It is a purification process, micro and macro. The only thing that will keep you balanced and centered is to meditate. Especially if you are an empath, especially if you are absorbing the energies around you, it is essential for you to go in the forest and to meditate. If you don't have a forest, it's okay, just meditate where you are. But find time to meditate. You cannot find that peace from the outer world, only going inside, and it is essential, really. I noticed that many people are asking, where is God? Why God is allowing all this to happen? What is happening on this planet is not easy to digest, and many people are still acting from the victim personality. And I want to remember you that with your free will, you decided to come on Earth to experience Earth, or you decided to help Mother Gaia in her ascension process, so you come. And as a co-creator being, you have your free will to experience whatever you wish. One of the laws of the universe that we are living in is the free will. So in this universe, having free will makes you responsible as a co-creator to be aware and to create with your heart. I think I said it before, but one of the most important lesson of humanity is to learn to say no. And because we didn't say no to certain things, they misguided us in these artificial timelines of suffering, of diseases, of being enslaved. And what is happening right now in the outer world can help us to finally learn to say no. No, we don't want a vaccine. No, we don't want to be enslaved anymore. We say no to corruption. When we say no to all these artificial timelines of suffering, of being enslaved, unconsciously, we say yes to God, we say yes to organic timeline, we say yes to love. You'll always, when you choose the organic timeline, you will always manifest as much as you need. Everything that you will wish to manifest with your heart, and that will help you to stay on that, on this organic timeline, will be there. It is manifested, very simple. And this is another key of manifestation: charging yourself with light, charging yourself with love. It will be more easy because you raise your vibration, so it will be more easy for you to manifest, and that manifestation will be as much as you need. It will always be balanced. You will never manifest something more than you need, because you ask with your soul and you visualize and manifest with your soul, and your soul trusts and your soul knows God's abundance, knows that you don't need to collect anything. So yes, choose the organic timeline. We all have this gate, this portal within our hearts to reconnect with Source, to live in harmony and in love, in oneness. And we can do it. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching. And be blessed in the name of God. Thank you.